Today we're going to talk about how important it is for a believer to be in the Word for ourselves. Let God tell me who I am. Let God tell me who He is. God's Word changes everything. So verse 20 is gold because the Son has His speech figured out. He knows what He's going to say to the Father. I know I don't deserve this. Just let me work for you. Just keep me out in the field. You know, He's got this all figured out because in His mind, that's as close as He's ever going to get to the Father, right? And when you're running from God, that's how you feel. There's no way to get to where I was, right? So maybe I can just get close enough to not feel so bad. I can still be a part somehow. That's the way logic, that's the way feelings talk. So verse 20 says, so He arose and He came to His Father. But while He was standing a long way off, His Father saw Him, felt compassion, and ran and embraced Him and kissed Him. And the Son said to Him, how thrown off did the Son have to be in that moment? He even tries to do a speech, right? He goes, this is what I was going to say. I'm going to say it. Father, I've sinned against You, heaven, and I've sinned before You. I'm no longer worthy to be called Your son. And the Father says, stop. It's party time. My boy's home, right? The thing that God's waiting on you do is, to do is not to fix the problem you made. Because the Father doesn't need our excuses. He doesn't need to know what got us there. He doesn't want to know all the guilt that we feel. He wants us. That's what He wants. And the more I see God's Word in here, the more I understand that God's not waiting on me to get back to Him when I run. He's waiting on me to get to a place where I realize that He was the source to start with. He was the source that was sustaining me. He was a source that's going to keep me. He's a source that's always going to chase me and hold me in. Because love's not waiting on me to get to Him. Love moved first. He made the first move. He made Him who knew no sin to become sin so I could be made right with Him. He put His Holy Spirit in me to make me His and seal me as His. And He's reminding me constantly who I am. And when I get off track, it's like the GPS of the Lord going, wrong turn, recalculating route, right? He's always drawing me back to Him. There's a difference between the God we feel and the God who is. The God you feel that we stitch together from how we compare to other people and what we're going through in our own little heads is always going to tell us that we're never going to make it back to Him and He doesn't want us back to start with. But what we see in His Word is that He didn't wait for us to find our way back to Him. We wouldn't be able to get back to Him even if it was our idea. But He made the way through Jesus. He draws us back to Him through His Holy Spirit. He's always moved first. God has shown me so much about His love for me in the story of the prodigal son. God has shown me that how He reaches out to get me and draws me back to Him. It was years before I started realizing this is a parable of two prodigal sons. One went away, one stayed home, but they were both just as dead inside. And when we start reading through verse 25, we see a bitter young man, a bitter son, who's stayed and done the right things and followed the rules and did all the stuff. And then brother gets to run out there, scratch all of his itches, and come back, and he's still a part of the party. I guess I would call it sin envy. Being mad at the world for getting to do whatever they want and being bitter in where we are and losing sight of what we do have. Because in the back of our mind, we're getting whispers in our head too, telling us they've got it better out there and they still get to come back. When I start thinking that way, my legs may not have run off, but my heart has. And God has shown me many, many times when I start seeing 2020 on people, and what they need to do. It's amazing how well I can see the sin of others, the flaws of others, and the things that they need to do better, and all the ways they need to change. Have you ever been in a sermon and thought, I know who needs to hear this? Danger. The moment you don't need to hear this is the moment we just join the team of the other brother. We start finding ourselves feeling like we've arrived, and now we don't need help anymore, so we can be the Holy Spirit's helper, right? And God has brought me here over and over. God has brought me to this scripture yesterday, all right? where I had to check myself and realize I'm a little bitter. There's some jealousy in me, and I'm making it all spiritual, so I feel better about it. But really, God, I'm mad at the world for being lost. I'm mad at sinners for sinning. I'm mad at hurting people for doing hurting things. When really, if I was where I was supposed to be, I would just be thinking, Lord, bring them home. Lord, bring them home. Lord, they're back. God, how can we keep them here, right? The story of the older brother is a story that everyone should read with their own eyes, in their own Bible. Walk through the phases he was in. Because the saddest part of this story is we don't see him come back. We don't see him realize that the Father's love is for everybody. He's just sitting there in his bitterness. And if I have a prayer for you, it's the same prayer that I have for me. God, show me my heart. Show me my life. What do I need to do? Because I can't make other people come to the Lord. I can't make people turn around. I can't make people see things the right way. I can't make them get saved. I can't make them trust Jesus. All I can do is love them where they are, give them truth in love, and pray that God does what only He can do, and that's bring them home. There's a lot of things happening in the world right now, and I get mad. You get mad? What do you do with that mad? If the way your mad works itself out is through your thumbs on social media, we can't do that. We gotta go to the Father first. We gotta go to Him first and say, God, how do I see them the way you see them? How can I love them the way you love them? How can I reach the way that you reach? If I wanna see them change my heart for them first. It's gotta start right here.